Hi there, Janine Johnson here, your 2020 car chair. And this is your one thing for October. We're a little late in October because we wanted to get it a little bit closer to the ballot time. And I'm here today joined by the Vice President of Government Affairs, Liz Peetz. Liz, thank you so much for being here.
Great to be here.
And as we all know, as our phone calls and our ads are stepping up, we know that the elections are getting closer and closer. I know that many of you have voted already, but we wanted to kind of talk to you about some things we've been doing at Government Affairs. And hopefully some of you have actually put it off so this information could be helpful. Liz, why is it so important that people vote?
Oh, Janine, absolutely. It's critical. This is one of your unalienable rights here in America. We are so privileged to have the right to vote. And it's the best way for you to make your voice known on both local issues and statewide issues. And we're so fortunate here in Colorado. Our system is what the rest of all the states are frantically trying to model when we get to vote at home. And I guess that's a good thing since our ballot is somewhat long this year, no matter what jurisdiction you're in, statewide or local. But it's really the best way you get to make your voice known on a presidential, state, and local level. So I highly encourage you to turn that ballot in as soon as possible, but definitely before 7 p.m. on November 3rd. You can't mail it on the 3rd. That would not be valid. Postmark doesn't work here in Colorado. So make sure you find your nearest drop.
Got it. That sounds great. Yeah, we have a Dropbox here, and it's just so convenient. I'm done, so I don't have to worry about it. But it is a long ballot. You're actually not lying. What is on the ballot this year that people should watch out for?
Yes. I can't name them all in our short time here, but I highly encourage that you check out the ballot guide for realtors that our state association has put out. We've taken positions on four important statewide issues. I'll just mention a couple today, but I highly encourage you to check out our webinars and our ballot guide on the CAR website under the Political Advocacy tab. So I'll just touch on two. Prop 117 actually gives you an opportunity to strengthen Tabor if you wish to do so. This is going to close a loophole that our legislature currently has that basically gives you another vote and say in whether or not we should put forward enterprises and fees. Under Tabor right now, you get to approve taxes, but the legislature over the past 10-ish years has found a workaround in Tabor and now uses enterprises as that way to increase costs on consumers. So if you want to strengthen Tabor, Prop 117 is one that you should definitely take a look at when you're voting. The other one I want to mention is Prop 118, and this is a family and medical leave benefit, but the reason it's really important for you to do your homework and figure out how you want to vote on this one is it is a statewide initiative that was put on the ballot and is funded by a lot of outside money. Over $8 million comes from outside Colorado in terms of putting this model in place. And I think what you need to consider is, do you want to fund a medical leave program that requires if you are in the private sector, it requires you to file your form to claim your benefits through a state administrator. And it will cost the state almost $1.3 billion to administer this program, which whether or not we think it's a good idea, I think we can agree benefits are a win-win. The thing you need to consider on this ballot is, do you want to fund a program that might be bankrupt within a year and a half? So I think we all want a program that works for Colorado, but maybe we want to find one that works for Colorado voters rather than California voters. Again, it's your vote and your choice. So get informed, and I highly encourage you to look up both Prop 117 and Prop 118.
Yeah, thank you so much. I agree. I mean, it feels counterintuitive. You're voting against something that we all strongly believe in, but it needs a mechanism behind it that works. Is there anything else that voters should know this year?
One of the things I would remind you, it is so secure to vote here in Colorado. We just don't have concerns about fraud or illegitimate voting. And part of that is because we've taken steps to protect our electorate, especially during COVID. So Janine mentioned drop boxes. There are additional drop boxes this year everywhere all around the state. So it should be really easy to find the nearest place to drop off your ballot. But we also have a statewide ballot trace system. So if you haven't signed up for it yet, this is a wonderful thing to do. I love it. They text me when my ballot is coming out. They text me when my ballot is being processed. It's such a great way to be transparent and hold your election officials accountable and know when you're voting. So I encourage you to sign up so you can watch your ballot in transit.
I did that, and it's great. I got an email or text, I can't remember which, maybe text, but that said my ballot had been accepted, which, you know, I know that it's not common, but if my signature didn't match or if it got pasted to another envelope or something, you know, at least I know that it's there and being counted. So, yeah, I appreciate that. That's amazing. Thank you so much for everything you do. I'm intimately involved in our government affairs division. I'm here to tell you guys, your members, that they do amazing work in that division. Well, all through CAR, but still, what Liz and her team do. So thank you so much for being here, Liz. I really appreciate it. And thank you, members, for checking in with this One Thing video. And I will see you next month for my final One Thing video. Until then, stay safe and stay warm. Thank you, everybody.